Let's see some questions based upon the shallow foundation theory. The first one here that I have taken is, the ultimate bearing capacity of a soil is 300 kPa. This Qu is equal to 300 kN per meter square. The depth of foundation is 1 meter. That is DF is equal to 1 meter. Unit weight of the soil is 20 kN per meter cube. Gamma is equal to 20 kN per meter cube. Choosing a factor of safety of 2.5, the net safe bearing capacity is. We have to find out the net safe bearing capacity. And factor of safety is given as 2.5. So it is a straightforward question. Net safe bearing capacity is equal to ultimate bearing capacity minus surcharge or overburden pressure, that is gamma times DF divided by factor of safety. So just we have to put the values. Ultimate bearing capacity is 300 minus 20 into 1 divided by 2.5. So from here it comes out to be 112 kN per meter square. That is B is the answer. Now after that, the next one is, the width and depth of a footing are 2 meter and 1.5 meter respectively. This is the footing, and here width is given as 2 meter and the depth is 1.5 meter. The water table at the site is at a depth of 3 meter below the ground level. This is the ground level, and from here the water table is at 3 meter. The water table correction factor for the calculation of bearing capacity. So when we saw the water table correction factor, so we take it in two ways, or separately for two parts, that is if the water table is there in this zone or if it is there in this zone. So how do we check it? So for this, the condition, or let me first write the formula. So the water table correction factor is given as 0.5 1 plus dW upon B. So here dW is the depth of water table, B is the width of the footing, and one more correction factor that is applied is 0.5 1 plus dW dash, if I write, divided by DF. If the water table is there in this zone, so this will be the dW dash, this value is the DF. So water table is not there in this zone, so we will discard this one. For this zone, we have to first check this condition, that is this ratio dW by B, it should be it should be between 0 to 1. So dW here is, this total depth is given as 3 meter and this part is given as 1.5, so this is 1.5 meter. So that is 1.5, and width of footing is 2 meter, so that is 1.5 by 2. So it is less than 1 and greater than 0. So this criteria is fulfilled, so we can apply this formula. If this ratio is greater than 1, then RW is simply equal to 1. That means the water table is not affecting the bearing capacity. So we can apply this formula here. RW is equal to 0.5, 1 plus dW is given as 1.5 divided by B is 2 meters. So here this value comes out to be 0.875. This is the answer. Now let's see the next one. A plate load test was conducted in sand on a 300 mm dia plate. So dia of the plate is given for a plate load test, that is width of plate, a dia of plate, that is 300 meter. If the plate settlement was 5 mm, so settlement of plate is also given. It is S of P is 5 mm at a pressure of 100 kPa. So the pressure at which the test is conducted is given, the settlement in mm of a 5 meter by 8 meter rectangular footing at the same pressure. So this pressure is given because to find out the settlement, the pressure which is applied on the footing as well as the pressure which is applied on a plate should be equal, then only we can move on to this formula, that is SF upon SP, which is applicable for cohesionless soil. So here nothing about soil is given, so we can apply this formula. SF upon SP is equal to VF upon VP multiplied by Vp plus 300 if we are talking in mm, and divided by Pf plus 300 square. So what all is given as F, we have to find out. Sp is given, Vp is given, and width of footing. Here the size is given, so width of footing will be the smaller size, smaller of the two. So in mm it is equal to 5000 mm. So just put the values in the formula, that is settlement of footing, settlement of plate is 5 mm, is equal to width of footing is given as 5000 and width of plate is 300 plus 300 divided by 300 to 5000 plus 300 square of this thing. So from here settlement of footing comes out to be 17.79 mm, which is almost equal to 17.8 mm, and that is the answer. Now after that, the next one is a strip footing 8 meter wide is designed for a settlement of 40 mm. So the width of footing, let's say B1 is equal to 8 meter, and total settlement corresponding to this width is given as 40 mm. The safe bearing capacity in shear was 150 kPa. So safe bearing capacity, I can write net safe bearing capacity is, let's say, 150 kilonewton per meter square, and safe allowable bearing pressure was 100 kilonewton per meter square. Let's say Qn allowable is equal to 100 kilonewton per meter square. Due to the importance of the structure, now the footing is to be designed for total settlement of 25 mm. Let's say S2 is equal to 25 mm. The new width of the footing will be, so we have to find the new width corresponding to this settlement, and the width corresponding to initial settlement is given, and these two values are given here, that is safe bearing capacity and safe allowable bearing pressure. So when I talked about safe allowable bearing pressure, so I mentioned that it contains two criteria, that is shear as well as settlement, and the minimum of these two governs our safe allowable bearing pressure, or the pressure for which we are going to design our footing. So here we can see that the footing is governed by the settlement criteria, so that's why these two values were given. Now we can avoid the shear criteria because the settlement criteria is governing, because this pressure is the lower or the lesser of these two values. So we have to use this Qn, I can say, is equal to 100 kilonewton per meter square. So for this pressure, the settlement was 40 mm, and the width of plate we adopted was 8 meter. Now we have to find out the new width. So if the settlement is going to be this much, then what is the allowable pressure on the soil? That we can simply find as by this relation, that is Q1 upon Q2 is equal to S1 upon S2. So from here Q1, let's see, Q1 we have to find, Q2 let's say it is 100, or the opposite one, let's say this is Q1, and Q2 we have to find corresponding to this value here. So here Q1 is 100 divided by Q2 is equal to S1 is 40 and divided by S2 is 25 mm. So from here Q2 is equal to 100 into 25 by 40, which is equal to 62.5 kilonewton per meter square. So obviously it is less than 100, because this relationship we are putting as Q is proportional to S. Why is it so? Because more is the bearing pressure, then we are going for more settlement, because the soil can sustain it, and less is the bearing pressure, then we will go for less settlement. So that's why it is proportional here. Now if this bearing pressure is less, or we can say the pressure which is going to be there on the soil is less, or we have to put this lower pressure, so we have to lower the pressure, it means that we have to increase the area of the footing. Now if the initial area, or at least initial width, was 8 meter, now this increased width, or the width which is going to be there, at this lower pressure, it should be more than this 8 meter because we are reducing this pressure. So it means that only two options are possible, that is 12 meter or 12.8 meter here. So now we can see, again apply this formula. So Q1 upon Q2, I can say here that if the allowable pressure on the soil is more, then the width can be less. So it means that Q is inversely proportional to B, because if the soil can take more pressure, if we can apply more pressure, then pressure is given as force divided by area. So if we are increasing the pressure, it means that we are decreasing the area. So that's why it is inversely proportional here. So Q is inversely proportional to B. So from here I can write Q1 upon Q2 is equal to B2 upon B1. And if we put the values, Q1 initially was 100 and later it was 62.5. B2 we have to find out, and B1 is 8 meter. So from here B2 comes out to be 12.8 meters. That is the answer. So you can simply relate it with this relation, that is pressure Q is equal to load, if I say F is the load, divided by area. So if allowable pressure is more, then we can take less width, and if allowable pressure is less, then we have to take more width. So that's why this Q I have taken inversely proportional to B, or from here we also we can say that Q is inversely proportional to area. The next one is the bearing capacity of a rectangular footing of plant dimension 1.5 meter by 3 meter resting on a sand deposit was estimated, resting on a surface of a sand deposit was estimated as 600 kN per meter square. So QU, if we say it is given as 600 kN per meter square, what else is given? This is our footing and it is resting on the surface of this sand. So this is our ground surface here, and dimensions are given. So width is the 1.5 meter and 3 meter will be in this direction. What else is given? When the water table is far below the base of the footing, the bearing capacity, so this bearing capacity is there when water table is far below the base of the footing. The bearing capacity when water table rise to depth of 3 meter, 1.5 meter and 0.5 meter. So three depths are given, that is from here it is 3 meter and then it is 1.5 meter and then it is 0.5 meter. And we have to find out the bearing capacity. Now there is this criteria, earlier also I said, this width of the footing. So it will be only affected, let's say depth of water table is DW. So when the DW by B ratio it is greater than 1, then this bearing capacity is not affected. So when what values are asked? 3 meter, 1.5 meter and 0.5 meter. For 3 meter we can see here. So DW, if it is 3 meter, width of footing is 1.5 meter. So this value is 2, obviously greater than 1. So the bearing capacity will not change. The next one is, that is DW is equal to 1.5 meter and width of footing is 1.5 meter. So that is 1.5 upon 1.5, which this ratio is equal to 1. This condition also, the bearing capacity will not change because it is just the limiting condition. So at this condition also bearing capacity is same, and after that, in the third condition, that is 0.5 upon 1.5. In this case only, bearing capacity is between 0 to 1. So this condition goes like this. It can be greater than equal to 0 and it should be less than 1. At equal to 1, the bearing capacity will not change. So here we see that for these two depths, that is 3 meter and 1.5 meter, bearing capacity is 600 and 600. And for this value, it is some thing else, that is Qx, let's say. If we see the options here, So there is only one option in which these two values are equal, that is 600, 600, and in any of the other option it is not there. So from here also you can directly do it. So let's we solve this for this 0.5 value. So when the water table is at 1.5 meter, then this value here it is equal to 600, and when it reaches at the surface, we know that in case of cohesionless soil, the bearing capacity is reduced to half. This value here is 300 kilonewton per meter square when the water table comes at the surface. So in between these two values, we can linearly interpolate. So here it is 300 and here it is 600, and from here we have to find at a depth of 0.5 meter. So let's say Qx is equal to 300 plus 0.5 divided by this total distance in which the change is happening is 1.5, and 600 minus 300. So from here Qx is equal to 400 kilonewton per meter square. So this is our option from here if we do the calculations. So after that, the next question here is, the unconfined compressive strength of a saturated clay sample is 54 kPa. So UCS, if I say unconfined compression strength, Q is equal to 54 kPa. So it is not bearing capacity here. Here I am denoting Q for the unconfined compressive strength. If a square footing of size 4 meter by 4 meter is resting on a surface of a deposit of clay, the ultimate bearing capacity as per Terzaghi's equation. So it is a square footing, and we have to find out the ultimate bearing capacity, QU. So for square footing, what was the formula for ultimate bearing capacity? 1.3 CNC plus QNQ plus 0.4 gamma B and gamma. But here we are talking about the saturated clay sample. So, and one more thing. So for saturated clay sample, this N gamma is equal to 0 and NQ is equal to 1. So it is 1.3 CNC plus Q. Now what else is given? It is resting on the surface of deposit. It means that Q is also equal to 0. So QU is equal to 1.3 CNC. Now it is given that we have to use Terzaghi's equation. So in Terzaghi's equation, in this condition, NC is equal to 5.7. So QU is equal to 1.3 into 5.7 into C. Now we have to find this C. So for this, this value is given. So from here we know that C is equal to Q upon 2, which is equal to 27 kilonewton per meter square. We can simply put this value here, 1.3 into 5.7 into 27. So from here it comes 200.09 or 200.07, which is almost equal to 200. So this is the answer here. After that, let's see one more question. So two more questions are there, but this theory is same. The multi-story building with a basement is to be constructed. The top 4 meter contains loose silt below which dense sand layer is present. So here I have drawn here this diagram. So this is a multi-story building and this is the basement part. This is the foundation also. So this part up to 4 meter, this is loose silt, and below this in this zone, it is just dense sand. What else is given? The groundwater table is at ground surface. So groundwater table is here. The foundation consists of basement slab of 6 meter. So this width here is 6 meter. I have mentioned this is 6 meter here, which will rest on top of dense sand. So below it, it is dense sand. So it is resting on dense sand. After that, for dense sand, saturated unit weight is, so for this part, saturated unit weight is given as gamma sat is equal to 20 kilonewton per meter cube. Or what else is given? NQ is equal to 40 and gamma is equal to 45. NQ is equal to 40 and gamma is equal to 45. And for saturated silt, for this part, gamma saturated is equal to 18 kilonewton per meter cube, n q is equal to 15, and n gamma is equal to 20. Effective cohesion c is equal to 0, and the elastic modulus e is equal to 60 into 10 to the power 3, and mu is equal to, that is Poisson's ratio is equal to 0.3. Factor of safety is equal to 3, and influence factor is given, that is 2. So this part of the question, or these values are given because the immediate settlement of the foundation is asked. What else is asked? The net safe bearing capacity is asked. So let's see. So first of all, ultimate bearing capacity, we know it is given as CNC plus QNQ plus 0.5 gamma B and gamma. Here nothing about the other length is given, so we'll assume it to be a strip footing. C here is 0, so this equation is just QNQ plus 0.5 gamma B and gamma. Now this part of the equation represents our surcharge. So surcharge is there below the or above the surface of the footing. So surcharge is consisting of loose silt, and this part of the equation, it represents our this area, that is shear zone. So we'll use NQ for the dense end, sorry, N gamma for the dense end, whereas NQ for the loose silt, because NQ is in this area and this term represents this part of the soil, whereas this term represents the below part. So here we'll use N gamma as 45 and NQ as NQ from this equation, this detail, that is 15. Rest of the things, one more thing is there, that is water table. The water table as at the surface, so we know that this, we have to find the effective weights. So Q, let's find first the Q ultimate, or let's say Q net ultimate. Q net ultimate is equal to Q and Q plus 0.5 gamma B and gamma minus Q minus the surcharge, so it is equal to Q into N Q minus 1 plus 0.5 gamma B and gamma. So Q net ultimate, here if we put the values, Q, what is the value of Q? Q is gamma DF, that is 4 into gamma. So gamma would be the, because this term is representing loose silt part, so gamma we'll use from this equation, but the water table is at the surface, so we have to take the submerged unit weight, so that is equal to 18 minus 9.81. so this part represents DF into gamma dash, that is submerged unit weight, which is equal to Q multiplied by NQ minus 1. So NQ also we have to take from here, that is 15 minus 1 plus, now this term, that is 0.5. here also we have to take gamma dash, but in this term we'll use this gamma, that is 20 minus 9.81 into B, that is 6 meter into N gamma. So N gamma we'll take as 45. So from this part we'll get the net ultimate bearing capacity, and we have to find the net safe bearing capacity. So net safe bearing capacity, QNS is equal to Q net ultimate divided by factor of safety. So you find this value in dividing by factor of safety, which is given as 3. So this value comes as 611 point something. So the closest value in this solution is 610. So the answer, that is net safe bearing capacity, is equal to 610 kilonewton per meter square. So that is the first part. And in the second part, the immediate settlement is asked. So for any immediate settlement, SI is equal to QN into B 1 minus mu square into influence factor divided by modulus of elasticity. Here nothing is given about whether it is a rigid or flexible condition, just the influence factor is given, so you need not worry about all that thing. Here Q is the net pressure on the soil, so that is our this pressure which we obtained from the earlier solution other all the other values are given, so we can put the values. This is 610 into b is 6, 1 minus mu square, 1 minus 0.3 square, influence factor is 2 divided by value of e, that is 60 into 10 to the power 3. 60 into 10 to the power 3. So from here, immediate settlement is, it is approximately 111 ms. So this is the answer here. So this finishes our discussion on Shallow Foundation.